Namaste. Welcome to CET NEET classes, Ray Optics. We have finished 26 questions. Now we will move on to the 27th one. Straight away we will jump into the job, right? A microscope is focused on a mark on a piece of paper and on a glass slab of thickness 3 cm is placed. Glass of thickness 3 cm, refractive index 1.5 is placed over the mark. How should the microscope be moved to get the mark focus again? Most of you will be doing this experiment, right? Real depth by apparent depth. So here is the position, here is the mark and here is the microscope, say. And the microscope reading on the vertical scale is like this, and this is the first reading when it is focused here. Mark on piece of paper, glass slab of thickness, glass slab of thickness, that is real depth, 3 cm is placed over it, and refractive index 1.5. Now the image shifts here, and now the microscope has to be shifted upwards so that this is R2, and this height and this height will be the same, right? Then placed over the mark. How should the microscope be moved to get the mark in focus again? Yeah, this is apparent depth, but we have to find out this one, right? So n is equal to real depth by apparent depth. What is apparent depth? Apparent depth is equal to 2 cm, right? 3 by 1.5, that is 2 cm. That means this is 2 cm. Mark appears to be at a depth of 2 cm. So how much you have to shift the microscope? That is this much amount. This is the amount to which you have to shift. The same amount, right? So if you focus camera using a mobile on a baby, what happens is if the object is focused, if the baby moves away by 3 meters, you are out of focus now. What you can do? You can also move by 3 meters so that the focus is remaining the same, right? So if the object moves away, keep on moving yourself away along with the microscope or mobile or camera. So the same thing. If this appears to be shifted here by keeping the glass slab, this also shifted. So how much you have to shift now? 2 cm is the shift in the object. Apparent depth. Then 1 cm is the shift in the object, then 1 cm upwards, yes, 1 cm upward, okay, right. Next problem, 28, a ball is dropped from a height of 20 cm above the surface of water to a lake. The refractive index of water is 4 by 3, I will mark it as I read it. There is a lake. And ball is dropped from a height of 20 meter above the lake. A ball is dropped. The refractive index of water is 4 by 3. Yes. And a fish inside the lake in the line of fall of the ball. Yes. On the line of the fall of the ball, a fish inside the lake is looking at the ball at the instant when the ball is 12.8 meter above the surface of water. So let the ball fall. And it is at a height of 12.8 meters above the surface of water. Okay, the fish sees the speed of the ball as. So what is the speed of the ball as seen by the fish? Now can you find out the speed of the ball as seen by the person who is outside water? That means in air. That is easy. X equal to V naught T plus half AD square, V square is equal to V naught square plus 2X. So when you drop a ball from a building or from a certain height, the velocity goes on increasing. That increasing velocity is same for all the persons in air. For your friend, for your teacher, for your mother, it falls at the same rate. But what about a fish inside water? It falls with a greater rate. Why? Because inside water, if you look into the outside world, by keeping yourself inside water, if you look into the outside world, everything appears to be far away, far away, far away, far away. Coconut trees appear to be longer, so you have to apply the formula n equal to apparent depth by real depth. The whole world appears to be bigger, and objects, in reality when you are in air, if the object falls through a height of 6 meters, but for a fish it appears to be n times more, because real depth by apparent depth is the refractive index when you are in air and only observe the objects in water or any denser media. But when you are inside water and when you observe the objects in the rarer media, it is apparent depth by real depth. So what is real depth? real depth, okay, what is apparent depth? Real depth into mu is apparent depth. That means everything appears to be longer and longer mu times. Same thing you have to do. Very simple problem. First of all, find out what is the speed of this ball when it travels through this distance. You know initial velocity is zero. Find out what is final velocity. As seen in air, multiply it n times. N means refractive index or mu times. That is the speed as seen by the fish. For fish, it appears to be longer and longer. It has to cover more distance for a fish because everything appears to be bigger. Okay, what we can do? In reality, v square is equal to v naught square plus 2ax. Now, x is not 12.8. 20 minus 12.8. 20 minus 12.8. 13.2. 7.2 meters. So, v square, don't know. V naught square, 0, dropped. Plus 2ax. 2g. Yeah, it is asked to take 10 meter per second square. X 7.2. V square is equal to, this is 14.4, 1.4, right? 2 2s are 4, 2 7s are 14, 14.4 into 10. So that implies V is equal to 12 meter per second. V cannot be negative, it should be positive. 12 meter per second for a person who is observing in air only. The activity is happening in air. No exaggeration, no contraction, no dilation, nothing. What about here? For the fish, velocity as seen by the fish with respect to fish is mu times 12, because everything appears to be mu times more. What is mu times 12? Mu is, I've written it 4 by 3. 4 by 3 times 12, 4 is 16 meters per second. Very simple. So everything appears to be mu times more. Length, speed, everything. Okay, option 3. Shall we move on? Next problem. Right. A person can see clearly only up to a distance of 30 centimeter. You know, better you read near distance, far distance, or near point, far point, and you have studied it in the lower classes. That is why it is removed from the syllabus. Don't be under the impression that it is out of syllabus for the entrance exam. It's a very simple one. I don't explain it. It is your job to read it yourself. The near point, far point and all. A person can see clearly up to a distance of 30 centimeter. Okay, that means within 30 he can't see, right? But usual normal persons can see up to 25 also. Within 25 they can't see. So he can see up to a person can see clearly up to a distance of 30. So beyond 30 he can't see, right? Clearly up to a distance of 30. Okay, he wants to read a book a place at distance of 50. At 50 he can't see, but he can see up to 30. Okay, then what is the power of the lens or the spectacles that he has to use? So, if the object is kept at a distance of say 30 centimeter, he can see, right? But a book is kept at a position of 50 centimeters, he can't see. Now, what we have to do? This image is clearly formed on the retina, but the book is here. What I can do is I have to use another lens here. So, place a lens here. An extra lens, what you call spectacle, such that the image of this object is formed at the place where he can see. That's all. Why do we use spectacles? Because eye lens, that our ciliary muscles cannot contract and expand beyond certain stage. So what the normal human beings see, the maximum and the minimum limit, infinity to 25, that capability is lost by the eye. So who will help us? Of course, eye has the capability of forming the image now also, but not as much as a normal human being, that's all. So how to help it with the separate lens? When you keep a separate lens, eye will do its own job. Along with that, lens will help it to form the images at the places where we can't see, that's all. So we can see up to 30, that is also one of the advantages. If you can't see even up to 30, you can't do anything, right? So you can see up to 30, that means if at 50 centimeter if you can't see means keep the object at 50, let its image is formed at 30, that because at 30 you can see, for that you use a separate lens. So now everything is, so lens will be here, either convex or concave lens, so like this here, Now, everything is in the left hand side. The rays of light are moving like this. And if you divide it into coordinate system, apply the Lenz formula. 1 by f equal to minus 1 by u plus 1 by v. For mirror formula, there is no negative here. We have magnification negative. So 1 by f is equal to minus 1 by u plus 1 by v. 1 by f is equal to minus 1 by u. U is this one. Book. 50 minus of minus 50, right? Why? Because this minus, formula minus. It is in the left hand side. Plus 50 plus 1 by v. 1 by v is the 1 by image distance. Image should be formed at minus 30. It is also on the left hand side. And sir, image is formed on the retina. Don't argue with like that. Now, image formed on the retina is by the eye lens. That is a separate part. Now, we are cooperating with the eye lens. So, that eye lens will get an object at a position where it can form the image. So, these are all the stories before the rays going into the eye. Then the story is different. But here is the story which is happening before the rays go enter into the eye. So, that is what we do. It is a retina image is different. Now we will cooperate with the eye so that image is formed at the place where I can accommodate it. So 1 by f is equal to 1 minus 1 by u plus 1 by v. What is f? 1 by f is equal to 1 by 50 minus 1 by 30. Am I right? That is equal to, shall I write 600? If I take 600, 50, sorry. Why 600? 150, 53s are, 35s are. So, what is 1 by f is equal to minus 2 by 150, okay, minus 2 by 150, f is equal to 1 minus 150 by 2 minus, oh, where did we go wrong? Right. It is, now we are asked to find out power, right? So, okay. Then focal length is minus 75 centimeter and f is equal to minus 0.75 meters. What is power? 1 by focal length, 1 by f, 1 by minus 0.75. This is one of the important thing you have to remember. Whenever power is asked, you have to convert the focal length into meters. That is a must. Otherwise, if focal length is in centimeter, power is in centimeter to the power minus 1. It is not diopter. Okay, that is equal to, 1 by minus 0.75, right? This is 1 by minus 3 by 4, correct? Because 0.75 is 3 by 4. 4 by 3 with a minus sign. Yeah, finish. 1.33 minus. That is the power of the lens he has to use. Okay. Then 30. A person cannot see distinctly any object placed beyond 40. So beyond 40 he cannot read. Calculate the power of the lens which will enable him to see the distance stars clearly. Okay. Stars are at infinite distance, very large distance compared to the focal length of the eye. Object distance is infinity. He wants to see the stars. Right? See his interest, right? He can't see beyond 40, but still he wants to see the stars. So he has to get the help from the lenses. That's all. Wear the spectacles, you can see the stars. So here is the eye, and infinity is the object distance. Stars are here, right? Yes, he must be able to see the stars. But the image of the stars, real stars, you can't bring the stars to 40 centimeters so that he can see the stars, right? That is not possible. So you have to bring the image of the stars at 40 centimeters where he can see. So use your lens, I think it's a concave lens, once again, use your lens in such a way that image of these infinite stars are formed at 40. This is infinity. Of course, this is minus 40. Everything coming on the left hand side opposite to the direction of light. Again, 1 by f is equal to minus 1 by u plus 1 by v. 1 by f, don't know, this is infinity plus 1 by infinity, 1 by v. 1 by v is 1 by minus 40. And you are asked to find out for that this power minus 0.4 from this side. So what is 1 by f? That itself is the question. 0.44 can be written as some 2 by 5, right? 2 by 5 is 0.4, yes. This is 1 by 2 by 5, that is equal to 5 by 2 minus 2.5 diopter. Yeah. Second option, minus 2.5. Hope I am not wrong. Minus 0.4, 40 centimeters, power is 1 by 2 by 5, minus 0.4, minus 5 by 2, 2.5, yes. Okay. So, always that from theory, that idea you have to use. The myopia, hypermetropia, every time we are using a lens in such a way that any object which is in the unseen position, its image has to be brought to the position where you can see. Yeah. 31. 30th we have finished, 31. When a telescope is in normal adjustment, the distance of the object from the objective from the eyepiece is found to be 100 centimeter. When a telescope is in the normal adjustment position, what do you mean by normal adjustment of a telescope? Of course, problem is very, very easy, provided you know about the telescope. And you must know also about microscope, but here I have taken only telescope. So you have an objective. Rays of light coming from the object almost parallel, because telescope is an object, as a device which is used to view distant objects. So parallel rays will be coming. They get focused at on a particular point, say this is the principal axis, and this is the focal length of the objective. This is a lens which is towards the object, not nearer to the object, towards the object. And there is an eyepiece kept here in such a way that this is also the focal length for focus for eyepiece. These rays getting into this become parallel, because this is the focus of the eyepiece. Because any ray parallel to the convex lens, they meet at focus. Any ray, diverging rays coming from the focus become parallel. So this, a person looking from here appear to be, he feels that these rays are coming from infinity, and this image is better than this image. If you directly look into the object from here, then those objects will appear to be smaller for him, the image. The image of these rays will be better. They will be larger comparatively. So size of the image when seen through the eye, when the object is seen with the naked eye is smaller. Size of the image when seen through the telescope is larger. That's why we get a better image. But no image is larger than the object, okay, here in the telescope, right? Now, this is called tube length. Now, magnification of any telescope is f naught by fe. And tube length is f naught plus fe, if it is using convex lenses. If you have these two formulas, then it is over. When a telescope is in a normal adjustment, this is called normal adjustment. The image formed by the objective should exactly lie at the focus of the eyepiece. And both the foci are same. From the eyepiece, it is found objective from normal adjustment, the distance of the objective from the eyepiece. Distance of the objective from the eyepiece is said to be 100, 1. Then, if the magnifying power of the telescope at the normal adjustment is 24, what is the, what are the focal lengths of the lenses? F naught is equal to 24 Fe. F naught is equal to 24 Fe. Substitute it here. F naught 24 Fe plus Fe 100. That implies 25 Fe is equal to 100. What is Fe? 4. 100 by 25. Once Fe is 4, substitute it here. Fe is 4. So it should be 96, because the total should be 100. F naught is 96. 96 and 4, yeah, fourth one, first one. So you must have an idea of this telescope, then only you can do it. But 32. Here is the refraction at curved surface and lensmaker's formula. Right, 32nd problem. Right, an air bubble in glass is situated at a distance of 3 centimeter from the convex surface, yes. I'll draw it. Here only sign conventions have to be taken care of, and everything you know it. So I will take the object, the curved surface, everything in such a way that ray of light always move from left side to right side, positive x axis. There is, and here is an object. Object is here itself. An object lies at a distance of 3 cm inside a convex surface of glass, refractive index 1.5. It is situated at a distance of 3 cm from the convex surface of diameter. Okay, diameter is 10 and radius of curvature is 5. And center lies here. If this is the part of a curved surface here, this is the center. Okay, then at what distance from the surface will the bubble appear? This is the pole. N1 by minus u. I call N1 as the refractive index of the medium where incident rays are present. I call always it like that. And N2 is the refractive index of the medium where refracted rays are present. Image distance. Refractive index of the medium where refracted rays are present minus refractive index of the medium where incident rays are present by radius. I always carry the formula like this. N1 and N2, I am not worried. Refractive index of the medium where incident rays are present, N1, by negative of the object distance. Refractive index of the medium where refracted rays are present, image distance. Now, if you observe, if it is observed from here, rays of light coming from the object and diverge, it is given like that here. That means they move in the positive x-axis, another ray like this, right? But distances have to be measured like this. So, incident medium is this one, refracted medium is one, R. Refractive index of the medium where incident rays are present, 1.5 by negative of object distance, minus 3. Because rays are moving like this, from the pole you have to measure the distance opposite. Then plus refractive index of the medium where refracted rays are present, 1. By image distance. Image distance, that is what you have to find out. And image distance, according to the diagram, image distance should be negative because it appears to be somewhere here. That we will see. Refractive index of the medium where refracted rays are present, 1, refracted rays, minus refractive index of the medium where incident rays are present. Incident rays are present in 1.5, divided by radius, this side. Rays are moving like this, you have to measure the radius here, minus 5. What else? 1.5 by 3, correct, plus 1 by V is equal to, this is minus 0.5 by 5, minus 5. That is 0.5 by 5. Now, shall I write this as 3 by 6 or 15 by 30? It is 1 by 2. 1.5 by 3 is plus 1 by V is equal to 0.5. I will take it as half. Minus minus gets cancelled. 0.5 is half, 1 by 10. That implies, what is 1 by V? 1 by V is equal to 1 by 10 minus 1 by 2. This one here. Take 10 common. 1s are, 5s are. Correct? And that is minus 4 by 10. Then V is equal to 10 by 4 minus 10 by 4. Minus 2.5 centimeter. Yes. Minus in the sense it is in this side. They are asking at what distance from the surface will the bubble appear? Somewhere here. Right? So sign convention is the only thing which you have to take care of here. Formulas, of course, you may be remembering. So here refractive index of the medium where incident rays are present. Negative of the object distance. Again another negative because it is in the left hand side. We don't know. And the incident medium, sorry, refracted medium minus incident medium here, 1.5, divided by radius, again negative. Rest of the things, calculations. So first option is answer. Shall we move on? 33. Parallel rays are incident on a sphere of 0.2 meter diameter and refractive index 1.5. The point of focus is at a distance of. Parallel rays are incident on a sphere of diameter and 0.2 meter diameter and refractive index, okay, sphere, okay, shall I do it somewhere above so that I will get enough space for calculation. Parallel rays are incident on a sphere like this of diameter, how much, 0.2 meter and refractive index 1.5. Half of this is 0.1, you know it. Now, the point of focus is at a distance of dash from the first surface itself. These rays will focus and focus again. Second time focus, like this. This is the final image distance. You can't apply lens maker's formula because in lens maker's formula, lens will be very thin. Here you can't assume it. It's a very thickness. Thin in the sense, the compared to the radius of curvature of the surfaces, thickness of the lens is very small. Whereas here, thickness is double the radius. You can't assume it as a thin lens. Now, we will apply the formula for two curved surfaces, one by one. First surface, second surface. First surface. N1 by minus U plus N2 by V, refractive index of the refracted medium, incident medium by radius. Refractive index of the medium where incident rays are present, R, 1. Negative of the object distance, infinity, parallel rays, plus refraction occurs here. Refractive index of the medium where refracted rays are present. Image distance, V1, that is from here to here, V1, if the second surface is absent, what would have happened? That is what you have to analyze, right? Suppose this is a glass of continued length like this. Second medium is not at all cut off. Then what should happen to the these rays of light? These will continue to move like this inside the glass. Suppose it is like this. Suppose it is like this, not cut here, continuous. They might have moved here. So what is V1? V1 is from here to here, right? It is V1. So refractive index of the refracting medium by image distance. Refractive index of the refracting medium, refracted rays, continuous, complete glass, minus incident medium by radius. Radius is, you see, this is the pole now. Radius is on the right hand side, so positive, right? This is the pole and the rays are moving like this. Center is here and it is this is the radius in this direction, positive, 0.1, but not 0.2, diameter 0.2. What is V1? This is 0. 1.5 by V1 is equal to 0.5 by 0.1. Isn't it? 0.5 by 0.1, that is equal to 5. What is V1? V1 will bring it here. 1.5 by 5, so that implies V1 is equal to 0.3. 0.3 meters. So, shall I write this as 0.3 meters? This is what I have got now. Now, for the second surface, these are the incident rays. 0.3 means it is away from 0.2, right? It should be away. For the second surface, this one here, these are the incident rays and these are the refracted rays. This one and this one. But where is the object for the second surface? I don't go for all these stories, you know it. You ask the first surface. First surface says, sir, I am getting incident rays like this. Where is the object? Sir, it is at infinity because they are parallel. They don't meet at all. Okay, you refracted the rays and made them to get focused here. You know this first surface has done its job. Now cut the second surface. You take a diamond knife and cut it and remove this piece. Then the rays of light move to air and come back here. Now for the second surface, these are the incident rays. You ask the second surface, where is the object for you, second surface? You are doing refraction now. Where is the object? Sir, I am getting three rays of light like this. If I bring them backwards, they diverge. So I will bring them forward here. This is the object. So what is the object distance for the second surface? That is this one only. What is this? 0.2 removed out of 0.3, right? 0.1. So we will write it now. For the second surface, which is showing refraction here, tell me, refractive index of the medium where incident rays are present, 1.5, by negative of the object distance, negative in the formula, what about object distance on the right side, 0.1, no additional negative, why? Because object is on the right side only. For this surface, this object is here, because these rays are appearing to come from here. So that is object distance. Negative of object distance, right hand side, no negative from our side, only negative from the formula. Plus refractive index of the medium where refracted rays are present, 1. the rays again come back to air, because this is cut off now. Then it need not pass through glass only, it has cut off. Image distance, don't know, that is this one. This is the final image distance. Image distance, but that is not the answer. They are asking you image distance from the first surface, that you have to remember. Is equal to refractive index of the medium with refracted rays are present, 1. Minus refractive index of the medium where incident rays are present, 1.5. Divided by radius, now come back here, radius is in this side. This one, maybe the value same but negative, you have to come to this side, minus 0.1. Every time when you write the refraction, that point or that pole where refraction is occurring is important. You have to start it from that pole where the refraction is occurring, right? Okay, now, you have to solve this. This is minus 15 by 1, multiply and divide by 10. Minus 15 by 1 plus 1 by V is equal to minus 0.5 by minus 0.1. It is 5, this is 5, this is minus 15. So what is 1 by V? 1 by V is equal to this minus 15 becomes plus 15, and this is 5. 15 plus 5, right? It is equal to 20. Is it so? V is equal to 1 by 20. That implies V is equal to 1 by 20. Did I go wrong? N1, refractive index of the medium where incident rays are present by negative of the object distance. Object distance is 0.1 because you have to remove from 0.3, you have to remove 0.2. Refractive index of the medium where refracted rays are present, 1 at the final image distance. Final image distance should be positive from this side, right? And the incident medium, refracted medium minus incident medium, radius again negative, left hand side, 115 by 1, this is correct, 1 by V, 5 by 1, 5, but this is plus 5, so plus 5, 20, V equal 1 by 20, 0.05 meters, 1 by 2 is 0.5, 1 by 20 is 0.05, if 1 by 20 is 0.05, that is to be added to 0.2, 0.2 plus 0.05, 0.25 meter, yeah, second option. So that is the thing, right? A little bit, it appears to be a little bit longer, but it is not a lengthy problem. You must be aware of all the sign conventions, and you must have an experience of solving this already. Yes, problem number 34. A parallel rays are incident on the plane surface of a hemisphere. Okay, that is a hemisphere, half sphere. Parallel rays are incident on the plane surface of the hemisphere. Then the point at which they get focused as measured from the flat surface. Yeah, flat surface means that surface which is plane. Here, hemisphere. Parallel rays are incident on the plane surface of the hemisphere. Sir, don't you show refraction here? No, because parallel rays are incident on the plane surface. I will take normal incidence. They move undeviated. Then here they get focused, right? So you need to worry about only this surface, this one, not this one, because here it is normal incidence and it moves. Parallel rays are incident on the plane surface of hemisphere, then the point at which they get focused. Radius is given here 20 centimeters and refractive index is given here 1.5. Okay, so you have to consider the refraction occurring under this surface only. So, for the rays of light undergoing refraction here, this is the pole, we will apply N1 by minus U plus N2 by V is equal to N2 minus N1 by R. You know this. Difference in the refractive indices by radius. Okay. N1 by minus U. I will take the refraction directly here because this I know. It is normal incidence, normal refraction. Yes. Refractive index of the medium where incident rays are present. By negative of object distance, infinity. Here also infinity, here also infinity, because their parallel rays are coming. N2, refractive index of the refracting medium, image distance from here. And it should be positive, because it is on the right hand side. N2 minus N1, refractive index of the medium where refracted rays are present, minus incident rays are present, divided by radius, this one. This is the center, because it is a hemisphere. Okay, some not like this, yes, center. Radius on the left hand side, minus 20, let the image be in centimeters. Okay, it is in this side. So what else will remain? 1 by V is equal to minus 0.5 by minus 20. Shall I write it as half, so 1 by 40. V is equal to 40 centimeters, sir. It's not meter. We have 40 centimeter. It's not meter, right? So direct problem. It is a part of the previous problem. Half part of the previous problem. Okay, then comes 35. A point object is placed 2 meter from the surface of a glass sphere of 0.5 meter radius. Okay, rub this, yeah. A point object is placed 2 meter from the surface of a glass sphere of 0.5 meter radius along the diameter. Yeah, same type of problem. A point object is placed 2 meter from the surface of a glass sphere of 0.5 meter radius, 0.5 and 0.5, diameter 1. 0.5 meter radius along the diameter. Position of the final image from the second surface is, from the second surface, refractive index is 1.5. Again, you have to go for the same procedure where parallel rays are incident, right? So, refractive index, this is object distance. The rays of light move like this, they undergo refraction, and if the second surface is absent, if this is continuous, these rays might have moved straight and formed the image here, and that forms the V1 for the first surface. And if the second surface is absent, that means if it is removed, the rays of light move like this. This is the final image distance. Okay. And now we will see the first surface, refraction in the first surface. Okay. N1 by minus U plus N2 by V is equal to N2 minus N1 by R. N1, refractive index of the medium where incident rays are present, 1. By minus U, minus in the formula, and this is the pole where the refraction is occurring, left hand side, minus 2. Plus refractive index of the medium where refracted rays are present. Image distance, first one, V1, after refraction through only first surface, no, this is not cut off, it is a full glass slab. So here, is equal to refractive index of the medium where refracted rays are present minus incident rays are present. Radius, you see, radius comes to the right hand side. It is positive. Positive radius means 0.5. Everything is in meters. Refraction is occurring here. Center is here. Radius here. When the refraction occurs here, you have to take negative. Correct? What else? Minus of minus 1 by 2. Half plus 1.5 by V1 is equal to minus 0.5. 0.5 by 0.5. 1. What is 1.5 by V1? 1.5 by V1 is equal to, half is 0.5, 1 minus 0.5, that is 0.5. What is V1? 1.5 by 0.5, that is equal to 3 meters. 3 meters means it is this one. Did I go wrong anywhere? 1 by 2, 1 by 5 by 0.5 by 0.5, correct. This is half 0.5, this one 0.5, 3 times. Yes, it is 3 meters. That means for this one, it is at a distance of 3 minus 1, that is equal to 2 meters. Why? This is from here 3, 3 minus this one, 1, right? 0.5 plus 0.5. So 3 minus this one, object distance for the second surface. For the second surface, this is the incident ray. And this serves as the object. So for second surface, N1, refractive index of the medium where incident rays are present. Negative of the object distance. Object distance lies here. That is this one. What is that? 2. Negative of 2. And there is no separate negative from our side, because for this surface, I am concentrating on this surface now. For this surface, this is the incident ray and the object appears to be here. So it is plus 2 only, but formula has a minus. Refractive index of the medium where refracted rays are present, 1. By image distance, that we don't know, that should be positive finally, is equal to difference, that is refractive index of the medium where refracted rays are present, 1 minus incident rays are present. Incident rays are here, 1.5. Divided by radius. Radius is on the left hand side. this one, this side. It is on the left hand side. Left hand side is minus 0.5. Did I substitute radius as 0.5 last time? Yes. Yeah, what is this one? I will multiply. 15, multiply and divide by 10. 15 by 20 minus. Right? It is 15 by 20, multiply and divide by 10. So, 3 is a 4 is a plus 1 by V is equal to minus 0.5 by minus 0.5. That is 1. So, what is 1 by V? 1 by V is equal to 1 plus, this becomes plus. This is, however, plus 1. 3 by 4. That is equal to 4 common. 4 common. 4, 4 1s are, 1 4 is 1 4, 4 1, 7. Simple one. 7 by 4. Hope you can see this. 7. What is V? V is equal to 4 by 7. V is equal to 4 by 7 meters. And from where it is asked, position of the final image from the second surface, from here only. 4 by 7 meters. Yes. The first one. 4 by 7 meters. Simple one. Same as the one problem earlier. Yeah. 35 is over. 36. A convergent beam of light is incident on a sphere of radius 20 centimeter and refractive index 1.5. The beam is convergent towards the farthest point of the sphere. Okay. A convergent beam of light is incident on, it is not a diverging beam, it is not coming from an object. It might have come from the object, but by passing through some lens or so, it has become convergent. A convergent beam of light is incident on a sphere of radius 20 centimeters. Okay, this part and this part and this is the 20. Okay. A convergent beam of light is incident on a sphere of radius 20 centimeter and refractive index 1.5. The beam is convergent towards the farthest point of the sphere. That means, if it is allowed to converge, it is convergent towards the farthest point of the sphere here. If you remove the sphere, then they are about to converge at the farthest point of the sphere. Farthest point of the sphere is here. But now the sphere doesn't allow it to converge here. What the sphere will do? This surface will bend it and it will converge it here. That is what this will do. It is not allowed to move forward like this. But if it is about to converge here, because this sentence, about to converge at the farthest point of the sphere, this says where the object is for the first surface, because of course no refraction is in the second surface, because it will just converge just before it reaches the second surface. So no question of second surface. So now if you ask the first surface, where is the object? Sir, they are diverging, but if they are produced backwards, here is the object distance. So, shall I apply n1 by minus u plus n2 by v is equal to n2 minus n1 by r, refractive index of the medium where incident rays are present, negative of object distance. Where is the object, sir? If they are diverging and you produce them backwards, they appear to converge at the farthest point of the sphere. So, this is the object distance. What is this? 40. 40, but positive because on the right hand side for this pole, and refractive index of the medium where refracted rays are present. Image distance, that's what you would find out, that should be positive finally. Refractive index of the medium where refracted rays are present minus incident rays are present. Radius is on the right hand side because this is the refracting surface, 20. Am I right? Refractive index of the medium are incident rays are present, are object distance on the right hand side 40 plus refractive index of the medium are refracted rays are present, image distance, refracted rays, incident rays by radius. So what is the answer? Minus 1 by 40 can be taken that minus 1 by 40 plus 1.5 by V is equal to 0.5 by 20. Now, shall I write this 0.5 by 20 as 1 by 40? Because 0.5 is half. Half 2 comes to the numerator, denominator, 1 by 40. So, what is 1.5 by V? 1.5 by V is equal to 1 by 40 comes to this side. 1 by 40 plus 1 by 40. 1.5 by V is equal to 2 by 40. You bring V here, 40 here. 1.5 by into 40 by 2 is equal to V. V here, 40 into 1.5. 40 into 1 and a half is 60. 40 half is 20 plus 40, 60. That is 30.3 meters. Yeah, 30 centimeter. That is better. 0.3 meters or 30 centimeters. What is the where is the image from? 30 centimeter from the first surface. And it is not asked from where, but that is the only possible answer. Okay, shall we move on? 37. Yes. A ray of light at a point at an angle of incidence 60 degree enters a glass sphere. So at one point it enters a glass sphere. Okay, let it enter. Glass sphere of refractive index root 3, n equal to root 3. Okay, then and is reflected and refracted at the farther surface of the sphere. Okay, at one point it is reflected and refracted. Okay, the angle between the reflected and refracted rays on this surface is, so there is a sphere. A ray of light incident at particular angle, say it is, so you have to draw a normal in order to find out the angle of incidence 60 degree. Joined to the center, a line drawn from the point to the center is a normal. Normal to this curved surface, it undergoes refraction here, and here this is the angle of refraction. This is the angle of refraction, and here it is incident at an angle R2. And they say that a part of the light gets refracted, a part of the light gets reflected. What is the angle between reflected and refracted rays? That is alpha. Question mark. Right? Correct. And this should be R2. It is given there also. This is also R2. Why? Because angle, if this is reflection, angle of incidence must be equal to angle of reflection. That is also R2. That is given there. And if you find out the reflected and the refracted rays, if this is refracted ray, if I continue this like this, this is the final angle of refraction or second angle of incidence, I can call. Yes, I2. Second angle. If a ray of light is incident like this, it will move like this. Now the question is, a ray of light at a point at an angle of incidence 60 degree enters a glass sphere of refractive index root 3. Okay. Then and is reflected and refracted at the farther surface of the sphere. The angle between the reflected and refracted is. Yes. Now this is radius. This is radius. Correct? Two angles are equal. Two sides are equal. Angle opposite to the equal sides must be equal, R1 and R2. So R1 is equal to R2 because these two sides are equal. They are the radii. R1 is equal to R2. Now can I find out this R1 and R2? Once I get R2, I can find out this. And once if I get this, I think I can find out this. Is it possible? Right? So we will proceed. 1 root 3. 1 sine 60 is equal to root 3 sine R1. What is sine R1? Sine 60 is root 3 by 2, root 3 sine R1, cut R1 is equal to 30 degree because sine 30 is half. 30, what else? 30, same, angle of incidence equal to angle of reflection. What else we have? I want to find out alpha, right? Again, we will apply Snell's law. Because I want to find out what is I2. Without I2, I think I cannot find out alpha because this is a straight line out of 180. So I can move this as a straight line. I will use some other chalk. Yeah, blue color. This is the normal going like this. This is this plus I2 plus R2. Remove it from 180. You get alpha. But how to find out I2? Root 3 sine, which is angle of incidence here. This one R2, but it's same as root 3 sine 30. Root 3 sine 30 is equal to 1 sine I2. Sine 30 is half, root 3 by 2, sine 30 is half, is equal to sine I2. What is I2? I2 is 60. Yeah, it is same as the angle of incidence. This is 60. Yeah, same as this one. If it is 60, 60 plus 30, 90. Remove this. 180 minus 60 plus 30, that is 90. 180 minus 90, yeah, here you have answer, 60 degrees, 90 degrees. So, very simple, some geometry and one Snell's law, that is all, finish. So one Snell's law here, another Snell's law here. And angle of incidence equal to angle of reflection here. And remaining things. Right, 38. The combined power of two lenses is 100. When they are separated by 20 centimeter. Combined power of two lenses is 100. But when they are separated by 20 centimeter, their power becomes 6.25 diopter. Okay. The powers of these lenses are. Right. Okay. The combined power of two lenses is plus 10 diopter. When they are separated by 20 centimeter, their power becomes 6.25 diopter. See, whenever two lenses are separated by certain distance d, now the power of combination, we know if they are combined, the focal length is 1 by f is equal to 1 by f1 plus 1 by f2. But if they are, the power is p is equal to p1 plus p2. If they are separated like this, 1 by f is equal to 1 by f1 plus 1 by f2 minus d by f1 f2. That implies the power of the combination is power 1 plus power 2 minus d into 1 by f1, 1 by f2, d into p1, p2. This is the formula. So, if two lenses are separated by a certain distance, the total power of the combination is p1 plus p2 minus the distance between them into p1, p2. 1 by f1 plus 1 by f2 is minus d by f1, f2. That is the reciprocal of focal length. So, we will use this formula. Now, I'll rub this. I'll use only the numericals. The combined power of the two lenses is 10 diopter. What do you mean by combined power? When there is no gap between them. That is usual formula. P1 plus P2 is equal to 10. And when they are separated by 20 centimeters, 0.2 meters, right? The power is 6.25. So, when they are separated by a distance, P1 plus P2 minus 0.2 P1 P2. I had put it everything in meters. Don't play with centimeters while you have diopter, right? P1 plus P2 minus 0.2 P1 P2 is equal to 6.25. Now only mathematics. What is P1? What is P2? Yeah, P1 plus P2, I can substitute this one here, correct? 10 minus 0.2 P1 P2 is equal to 6.25. You bring this here, bring this here. 10 minus 6.25 is equal to 0.2 P1 P2. 3.75, yes, 0.2 P1 P2. 0.2 is 1 by 5, right? That means into 5. Into 5 means 25, 37, 18.75 is equal to P1 P2. So you have product. You have sum, but if you have sum and different, x plus y and x minus y, simultaneous equations you can solve. But how to get x minus y? P1 minus P2 whole square is equal to P1 plus P2 whole square minus 4 P1 P2. This is a mathematical formula. A minus B whole square is equal to A plus B whole square minus 4AB. You know that formula. A minus B whole square is equal to A plus B whole square minus 4AB. So this gives P1 minus P2 whole square is equal to P1 plus P2 whole square, 10 square, minus 4 into P1 P2, 18.75. P1 minus P2 whole square, 100 minus 18 fours are 72, and this 0.75, 0.75, 0.75, 0.75, 4 times, 3. 75. What is P1 minus P2? 5. Because whole square is 25 and P1 minus P2 is 5. P1 plus P2 is 10. Now simultaneous equation. 2P1 is equal to 15. P1 is equal to 7.5. But totally should be 10. But what is P2? 2.5. Where is it? 7.5 and 2.5, both positive. Correct. Option 3. Right. This is the 39th problem. In the diagram given below, okay, focal length of the convex lens is 0.2 meter, focal length of the other lens is. So there are two lenses. One lens is kept here. It is somewhat like telescope. In a telescope, we have an objective and eyepiece. Here is a lens and here is an object, and it gives away two rays of light and forms the image here. But before forming the image itself, another lens disturbs it, convex lens, and makes the two rays parallel to each other. So like this, like this, like this, and these rays become parallel to each other, okay, like this, before they get focused. Why it is so? Because in a convex lens, you know that if parallel rays are incident on a convex lens, they meet at a point called focus. The reverse is also true. If you keep the object at focus, these rays become parallel. The same thing happens in the case of concave lens also. So what does concave lens do? If parallel rays are incident on a concave lens, like this, they diverge in such a way that they appear to come from focus, right? They appear to come from focus here. This is the focus and this is the focal length. Now, suppose you keep reverse it. That means if two or three focusing rays are disturbed by a concave lens like this, and these rays are not allowed to focus now. Suppose they are left by themselves, these rays will get focused here. Now, if a concave lens is kept in between, such that these focusing rays or converging rays are disturbed here, such that this itself is the focal length of the lens, what happens then? These rays become parallel. Why? Because you know that if parallel rays are incident on a concave lens, after diverging, they appear to come from the focus. If the focusing rays are disturbed by a concave lens, they become parallel, provided the point about to which they are getting focused, it should be the focal length of, should be the focus of the concave lens. The same thing happens here. It is the reverse case of parallel rays. When parallel rays are incident, they diverge and appear to come from focus. If focusing rays are incident, they become parallel. Okay. Now, if this lens has to form parallel rays for this one, then this focusing point should be the focal length of the concave mirror. Because if parallel rays are incident on this concave mirror, like this, reverse, if I reverse this, they should diverge in such a way that, like this, of course, now the situation is different. The rays are coming from here and they are getting focused here. They are about to focus here. So if the focusing rays are given, they become parallel. But if parallel rays are given, they diverge in such a way that they should appear from the come from the same focus here. Correct? So that means this should be the focal length. Hope you have followed, right? Right. Now, how to find out that focal length? They are asking the focal length of the other lens, concave lens. This is given object distance for this lens, and the focal length of the convex lens is 0.2. And you find out the image distance first. You find out the image distance for the lens. Let the rays keep on moving, form the image here. If that image distance can be obtained, then remove 0.16 from the image distance, you will get what is the focal length. From this distance, remove this one, you will get the focal length of the concave lens, right? So how to find out the image distance? 1 by F is equal to minus 1 by U plus 1 by V. 1 by F, 1 by focal length of the lens. It's a convex lens. When parallel rays are incident on it, they focus on the right hand side. Focal length positive. 1 by 0.2. 1 by minus from the formula. Object distance on the left hand side. Again negative. Minus 0.45. Grab this. Minus 0.45. Plus 1 by V, don't know. V should be positive because the rays are coming on the right hand side, right? They form the image on the right hand side. It should be positive. I will bring this. This becomes plus. When it comes to the other side, negative. That comes to 10 by 2 minus, because this is minus or minus plus, 100 by 45. Did you follow my method? This is 1 by 0.45. Multiply and divide by 100. 100. 0.45 becomes 45. This is 100. And minus or minus plus. But when it comes here, minus. That is 1 by V. That implies 90 common I'll take, 245 za 450 minus 45 2 za 200, that is 1 by V. Shall I write it here? So V is equal to that is 90 by 250. 0 getting cancelled. 25 9 0.3 75 then 15 remaining. 15 6 are 0.36. So 0.36 minus okay. This is 0.36, right? Not 0.35. It is 0.36. If this is 0.36 minus 0.16 gives the focal length. So this is 0.36 minus 0.16, that is 0.2, right? 0.2 is this one. That is the focal length of the lens. So this combination, so that reversing the rays of light, you must know. The last one, convex lens of focal length, 25 centimeter. It is a similar one, but given in the form of sentences, no diagram. A convex lens of focal length, 25 centimeter, is placed at a distance of x from a concave lens of focal length, 7 centimeter. Yes, a convex lens of focal length 25 centimeter. Yeah, convex lens of focal length 25 centimeter is placed at a distance of a concave lens of focal length. How much? 7 centimeters. When a parallel beam of light is incident on the convex lens, yes, yeah, the convex lens, it emerges as parallel beam of light from the concave lens, yes, they get focused here and they become parallel, same problem. But if that lens is removed, if this is removed, these rays will come and get focused here, they will form the image, okay, not bending, just directly coming over here and forming the image here. They might have formed the image here, but that is not allowed by this concave lens. So what is the, and they are separated by the parallel beam of light photon which placed at a distance x, yes. What is this x? This x should be, this should be the focal length, right? If parallel rays are incident on a concave lens, right, they should diverge in such a way that they should appear to come from the focus. So this should be f of the focal length of the concave lens, that is 7 centimeters. You can find out x once you get this one. So what do you mean by, this is a very easy problem since the rays are parallel. See, what do you mean by focal length of the lens? When parallel rays are incident on a lens, they meet at a point, that point is called focus. So this should be 25 focal length of the lens, and out of 25 remove 7, 25 minus 7, that is 18 centimeters, that is the answer, second one. Oh, this is a direct problem then, right? As you understand the previous one, this becomes an easier problem. So these are the some of the problems, and I stop ray optics at the time being, and if the time permits we will have more questions, and for NEET exam also, because we have enough time. For CET we will be discussing this much, and if there is time, of course definitely I will work out more problems. So I will give you some papers, work out more problems, try to answer them, and we will meet in the next class with the wave optics, right? Wave optics, and we will have more questions on that. Till then, keep working, work on some other problems. Thanks for watching my video, and we will meet in the next class.